State Public Service Commission, SSC Combined Graduate Level and CLAT examinations. So do visit AKS IAS Academy and also the website of AKS IAS Academy. And about me, I am Sandeep Bhushan Tumala and I have 10 years of teaching experience for civil services. I teach international relations and internal security and the analysis of the Hindu newspaper. And this session will certainly help you to crack prelims and mains examination, because throughout my session I would be emphasizing on the keywords and the key phrases from the daily news analysis or in the daily news analysis, wherein by emphasizing on the keywords and the key phrases you can identify the factual, analytical and conceptual questions for the prelims 2020, and as well as while you imbibe the keywords and the key phrases in your answer writing, that is making a point in your short notes for the mains examination. And if you write these keywords or imbibe these keywords and the key phrases which we will be discussing in the daily news analysis, if you imbibe that in the answer writing, your answers would be precise and concise in the mains examinations. So therefore you can score higher marks in the mains examination. So the AKS IAS Academy daily news analysis, this session will help you to score higher marks in the mains 2020 as well as prelims and mains 2021. So do follow the complete session of AKS IAS Academy and do get benefited of the entire session. And this session is in regards to the DNA, that is daily news analysis of today, of 3rd of November 2020 of the Hindu newspaper. And before we get into the DNA, we would just look at the quote of the day. And the quote of the day is, big ideas have a small beginning. So do not think that whatever you are doing or whatever the initiative you have taken is small. No, definitely that will leap and you will certainly succeed one day. So that will attain a big ideas and your dream will come true. And I would say a very good morning to all the one who are in the live and also in the live chat. David, a warm welcome to you. Ajay Ram, Mohammad Razak, Mustafa, Gauri Naidu, Ajay Ram, Ranganath, Pantangi, Pavan, all of you a warm welcome to AKS IAS Academy daily news analysis. And Mohammad Razak says that about 6:30. As of now, Razak, the timing will be of 7:30 itself as of now. If there is any changes, I will let you know in advance 1 week. But from as of now, the timing will be 7:30 for the AKS IAS Academy daily news analysis. And David says, sir, you are doing great job by providing. Okay, thank you. I would also say a very big thank you to everyone who are following this. And then do definitely get the benefit from AKS IAS Academy daily news analysis. D. Suvarna has joined, S. Naresh, S. Nagaraju, all of you a warm welcome to AKS IAS Academy daily news analysis. And now we'll get into the DNA of the Hindu newspaper. And the news which we will be focusing is Supreme Court has stayed an election order. It has stayed. So who has stayed? Supreme Court has stayed an election order revoking the status of what? Revoking the status of star campaigner. So here the keyword is star campaigner. The star campaigner status of Kamal Nath of the Indian National Congress has been revoked by the Election Commission. So as the Election Commission has revoked, or it has changed the person, that is the Kamal Nath status of star campaigner in the election campaigning, now the Supreme Court has stayed in the sense it has put an halt to that. So on October 30, the Supreme Court has passed an order of making it very clear that the order which has been passed by the Election Commission has been put on stay of stating or revoking the star campaigner of the former Madhya Pradesh Chief Minister Kamal Nath. So Kamal Nath is is the former Madhya Pradesh Chief Minister, and he has been going ahead with campaigning in the Gwalior district, wherein he was campaigning in a campaigning election rally at Dabra, and he has made a statement or derogatory statements against a candidate, that is BJP candidate. The name of the BJP candidate is Imarti Devi. So as he has made his derogatory statements against the BJP candidate Imarti Devi, and then a complaint was filed from the BJP onto the Kamal Nath, that is with the election commission, and then the election commission has revoked his name as the star campaigner in the Gwalior district, or else star campaigner of the Indian National Congress. Now the point here is, Supreme Court is asking this election commission, or it has put a stay on the election commission order, saying that a 3-judge bench of the commission of the Supreme Court, it says that the election commission had no power. Look at it. Now it is Supreme Court versus election commission. Please do focus this. This is for prelims as well as mains examination. This information is for prelims as well as mains. Why prelims? Because you need to focus in regards to the election commission. The role or else the rules of it, of the election commission. All the articles which are pertaining to the election commission, you need to focus in regards to the polity point of view for UPSC prelims perspective. And when it comes to mains point of view, it is the kind of what is the role of the Supreme Court, the role of the Supreme Court in revoking the order of the election commission, in revoking the order of the election commission. So here what you need to focus is Supreme Court versus election commission. When the election commission has revoked the star campaigner status of Kamal Nath, when a BJP person has complained with the election commission, and now the 3-judge bench of the Supreme Court has made it very clear that the one who is heading the 3-judge bench is the Chief Justice of India, Sharad A. Bobde. The CJI of the 3-judge bench of the Supreme Court, which is headed by the CJI, he says that the election commission had no power to determine who should be the star campaigner of the political party. This is the crucial statement made by the 3-judge bench of the Supreme Court, headed by the Chief Justice of India, Sharad A. Bobde, saying that the election commission had no power to determine who should be the star campaigner of the political party. And then the election commission has found Mr. Kamal Nath guilty of violating the model code of conduct when he was campaigning an election rally in the by-election in the Gwalior district. So election commission has revoked the star campaigner in the elections of Mr. Kamal Nath, the former Chief Minister of Madhya Pradesh, saying that Mr. Kamal Nath has violated the model code of conduct, and he has been revoked the star campaigner of the Indian National Congress. But the Supreme Court has said that you do not, that is the election commission has no power to determine who should be the star campaigner. So please do understand, this is Supreme Court versus election commission. This is very, very important topic for UPSC prelims as well as mains examination. And before I get into the next topic, Mustafa and then Madhu, Harika Yadav, Sai Kumar Gaut, a warm welcome to you all to KSIS Academy Daily News Analysis. And now we will look at another concept or the keyword. Here the keyword is prerogative of party. Prerogative in the sense, it is up to the party, up to any political party to decide who will be the star campaigner in the elections. And here the one who was representing Kamal Nath in the Supreme Court is the Kapil Sibal, who is the senior advocate, and advocates Varun K. Chopra, they have said that deciding the star campaigner will be the prerogative of the political party and not the election commission to remove the name as a star campaigner. Look at it. The keyword here is prerogative of the party. So who has the right or the power to decide who will be the star campaigner? It is the that political party of that political person who is campaigning for the elections, but not the election commission. But only the political party will decide who will be the star campaigner. And as per the section 77 of 1 of the Representation of the People's Act 1951, this is the keyword which you need to focus, wherein you can add it as your short notes in your mains answer. So as per section 77 of 1 of the Representation of People's Act 1951, it very clearly gives the guidelines. It very clearly mentions the guidelines for the star campaigners issued by the Election Commission from time to time, makes a revocation of star campaigners the sole prerogative of the political party. So, as per the section 77 of 1 of the Representation of People's Act 1951, it very clearly states that the star campaigner for any political party is as per the sole prerogative of the that political party. So here section 77(1) of the Representation of People's Act 1951 is crucial. And then who will frame the guidelines, that whether it is that X person will be the star campaigner of any political party. So another keyword here is the framing of guidelines. So now the senior advocate, that is Kapil Sibal, who is representing Kamal Nath in the Supreme Court against the Election Commission revoking the star campaigner of Madhya Pradesh, former Chief Minister of Madhya Pradesh Kamal Nath. So Kapil Sibal has urged the Supreme Court to frame an appropriate guidelines for speeches during or while election campaign, that the framing of the guidelines by the Supreme Court, which has been urged by the Kapil Sibal, should be kept in mind the right to freedom of speech, expression and concept of democratic elections. So here the keywords what you need to focus is the right to freedom of speech and the concept of democratic election. Please do understand, here it is the concept of democratic elections have to be kept in mind along with the right to freedom of speech and expression is the point which has been urged by the advocate Kapil Sibal to the courts to frame guidelines for the speeches while delivering, while or during the election campaign. And election commission revoking the name of Kamal Nath as a star campaigner, he says, that is Kapil Sibal, he is saying that it is hampering or delaying the principle of free and fair and level playing field in elections. So these are the crucial keywords which you need to certainly keep it in mind and then add it in your short notes. That is, it is hampering the free and fair and level playing field in the elections. That is what the Kapil Sibal, senior advocate representing Kamal Nath in the Supreme Court, has urged the Supreme Court to frame an appropriate guidelines for the speeches during campaigning. So this is this Supreme Court staying the election order of revoking the star campaigner status is very crucial information. And then Sai Kumar Gowd has joined. A warm welcome to you, Sai Kumar. And now we will look at the another news which talks about accountant Attorney General declines consent. Consent means it is the acceptance. It is the permission. Consent means permission. So, Attorney General declines the permission for contempt of case against Jagan Mohan Reddy, that is the Chief Minister of Andhra Pradesh, and also against the principal advisor of Chief Minister Ajay Kallam. So here the point is that a contempt of case is to be initiated. A contempt of case, that means the one who is raising a point or who is not respecting the court, is that is called as the contempt of case, which is being initiated or want to be initiated against the Andhra Pradesh Chief Minister Jagan Mohan Reddy and the principal advisor of Chief Minister of AP Ajay Kallam. Here the Attorney General KK Venugopal has declined the consent. That means there need not be any permission to initiate the contempt proceedings against the Chief Minister of Andhra Pradesh Jagan Mohan Reddy and the principal advisor. Do understand here, Attorney General is responding to the petition filed by the Supreme Court advocate Ashwin Kumar Upadhyay, that the Supreme Court advocate is asking the prior permission from the Attorney General to initiate a contempt case against Jagan Mohan Reddy. And when the petition was filed, the response to the petition by the Attorney General, that is KK Venugopal, is saying that he has declined. There is no need for the Attorney General to give permission to initiate contempt of proceedings against the Chief Minister of Andhra Pradesh Jagan Mohan Reddy. And this petition was filed by Ashwin Kumar Upadhyay for prior consent. Prior in the sense before or permission. Prior is before or permission, consent, before taking a beforehand permission. Under what? Under the Contempt of Court Act. So as per an act, that is Contempt of Court Act, to initiate the proceedings against Mr. Reddy and Kallam. Okay, the point is that why the Supreme Court advocate Ashwin Kumar Upadhyay wants to initiate a contempt of court against Chief Minister of Andhra Pradesh and the principal advisor is because we will look at it here. KK Venugopal, Attorney General, has made it very clear that on September 16th of 2020, there was an order which was passed by Justice Ramana, wherein the order is to direct pending prosecution of elected representatives to be taken up and disposed expeditiously. That means on September 16, 2020, Justice Ramana has directed to go ahead with taking up the pending cases of the elected representatives, that is MLAs or MPs, that has to be taken up and disposed expeditiously. That means very fast. So this was an order which was passed by Justice Ramana on September 16, and on October 6th of 2020, the Andhra Pradesh Chief Minister Jagan Mohan Reddy has written a letter, and that letter was released by the Principal Secretary Kallam at a press conference on October 10th. So look at it, the sequence. First is the September 16th, wherein the Justice Ramana has passed an order directing that pending cases has to be taken up against the elected representatives, that is MLAs and MPs, and it has to be disposed. That means it has to be taken up very fast. And on October 6th, a letter was prepared, or it was drafted by Reddy. And then on the third one, which is on October 10th, if you look at, it was released to the press. And what Venugopal, that is Mr. Venugopal, Attorney General of India, is saying that there is a suspect in this entire sequence, that is September 16, October 6th of the letter, and then October 10th bringing it to the press, the October 10th. All this is a suspect. which is in background to the what the order passed by Justice Ramanna. Justice Ramanna to take up the cases very seriously and fast against the MLAs and MPs. And he says that Attorney General, he has responded to Supreme Court Advocate, the petitioner filed Mr. Upadhyay's statement that Mr. Reddy, that is Jagan Mohan Reddy, had 31 criminal cases against him and he did not really give any kind of permission to initiate a contempt of court, because already the letter which has been written by Mr. Jagan Mohan Reddy to the Chief Justice of India. So the case is before the Chief Justice of India. As the letter has been written by the Chief Minister of Andhra Pradesh to the Chief Justice of India, Sharad Bobde. So definitely now the case is with the Chief Justice of India. And in this context, the Attorney General is saying that it is not required to give me a prior permission to initiate a contempt of court action against the Contempt of Court Act towards Mr. Reddy and that is the principal advisor Mr. Kallam also, and Mr. Upadhyay's PIL, that is public interest litigation, against the criminalization of politics. This is the key word here. The key word in the entire process is the criminalization of politics. What you will get in the exam is this is the keyword in regards to the criminalization of politics and the long pending trials against the legislators, and wherein the top court, that is Supreme Court, has given an order of setting up a special courts to try MPs and MLAs expeditiously, that is very fast. And the bench led by Justice Ramanna is presently monitoring. So here in this case, as the Supreme Court has already said that there has to be set up in the year 2017 itself, in the year 2016-17 itself, the Supreme Court has said to set up a special courts to try MPs and MLAs which are having any pending prosecution cases against them. So there is nothing wrong in it as per the petitioner file, and the bench which is led by Justice Ramanna is taking up the case in regards to making sure that there is the prosecution against the elected representatives which has to be taken at a expeditiously manner. Pravelika says Telugu law, okay, but I'm extremely sorry that I cannot really explain in Telugu, but I will try to use very simple English and then I will make sure that you follow it. You will understand it. And there is another news which talks about High Court panel questions setting up of a special courts to try MPs. So again here the keyword is special courts. We have looked at in the previous news also that the Supreme Court has asked to set up the special courts to make sure that all the pending cases can be taken up at an expeditiously process. That means expeditiously process, that is at a faster pace. So what are special courts? The special courts are the one which are taken up so that all the pending cases can be taken up fast, and then it will be taking up with a very fast process. So the process would be simple and fast, so that the pending cases could be taken up at a faster pace. But we have a news which talks about the High Court, that is the Madras High Court has a committee of a three judge committee, and the Madras High Court of three judge committee is now questioning the constitutional validity of setting up of special courts to exclusively try MPs and MLAs wherein there are pending cases against the MPs and MLAs. I did say in the year 2016-17 the Supreme Court has ordered to set up the special courts to to try or to exclusively try the MPs and MLAs wherein there are pending cases against them in regards to various crimes. But now look at it here. The 3-judge committee of the Madras High Court, please do take it into consideration, which court has questioned the constitutional validity of setting up of special courts to exclusively try MPs and MLAs? It is Madras High Court. And this Madras High Court, the 3-judge committee, it says that the special courts should be offense centric. That means a kind of crime which has been committed, crime centric or offense centric, and not offender centric. Please you understand. Here they are saying that the special courts should be based on the, this is the keyword, offense. That means the particular crime which has been conducted, but it should not be based on the offender. That means who is part of it, or else the trial is taking place. And the Madras High Court also makes it very clear that an MP or an MLA who commits an offense on the POXO Act, that is in regards to the Prevention of Corruption Act or Narcotic Drugs and Psychotropic Substances, look at it, the logic what the Madras High Court committee is saying. It says that any offense committed under the POXO Act or the NDPS Act, that is Narcotic Drugs and Psychotropic Substances, can be only tried by special courts created under POXO Act. Please do understand here. So the courts, special courts which are created under the POXO Act, can only try an MP or MLA who has committed an offense under the POXO Act or the NDPS Act. And they say that there cannot be any other special courts exclusively created to try an MP or MLA who commits POXO offense. You understood this point? The point here is the Madras High Court committee is saying that if an MP or MLA has committed an offense under POXO Act or NDPC Act, they have to be tried, or they have to be, the case can be taken up only by the special court created under the POXO Act, but they cannot be tried under the special courts which is being created just because the Supreme Court is saying who commits POXO offense. Please do understand here. The keyword here is special courts and then the 3-judge Madras High Court committee. And the Madras High Court committee reported that October 13, which comes into phase of 2017. So 2017, the Supreme Court, as I said, it has authorized the center to set up 12 special courts. This is very important information for your understanding. In the year 2017, the Supreme Court has ordered and authorizing the center to set up 12 special courts exclusively to try criminal politicians across the country. Look at it, the kind of cases which are pending in India against the politicians or the people's representatives, it could be MPs or MLAs. Therefore, the Supreme Court in the year 2017 has ordered authorizing the center to set up special courts to try criminal politicians across the country. And this is how the point is now, because now we have seen in the previous topic also that a 3-judge bench of the apex court, which is led by Justice N.V. Ramana, is also looking ways to expedite the same kind of criminal proceedings against the politicians which are pending for decades. And there are 4,400 criminal trials pending against legislators, and out of 4,400, only 2,500 trials involve sitting legislators. And look at it, this is the way why more than a decade, Justice N.V. Ramana is saying that is why we need to expedite. That means we need to make the process or the trials which are pending to dispose it very fast, so that we need the special courts. But the Madras High Court Criminal Rules Committee, on special courts for trials of the criminal cases against MP and MLAs. They say that the special courts cannot be set up. Please do understand here the linking. I said in the year 2017, the Supreme Court has come up with an order authorizing the center to set up 12 special courts. And now the Madras High Court Criminal Rules Committee is challenging the 2017 Supreme Court order to authorizing the center to set up 12 special courts. Why? It says that the Supreme Court do not have the right, or it cannot say, to set up the special courts on the basis of judicial or executive orders. It can be, that means special courts can only be constituted by a statute, that is through the parliament, and not by an executive or judicial fiats. Fiats in the sense order. And this is what is the now the Madras High Court Committee versus Supreme Court here. Please do understand. And this is on what? Setting up of special courts. And this is very, very crucial for polity point of view, for prelims as well as mains perspective. Madras, in the year 2017, Supreme Court has ordered the center to set up 12 special courts to try the criminal politicians across the country. But the Madras High Court criminal rules say that special courts cannot be created on the basis of judicial or executive. It can be constituted only through a statute, that is through the parliament itself. And now look at it. This is very, very crucial information for the prelims as well as mains in regards to the special courts, setting up of special courts, which can be very, very useful information for the mains 2020 GS paper 2. Polity. Azmat Khan has joined. A warm welcome to you, Azmat Khan. And there is another news which talks about Rajasthan passes bills to stall centers form laws. So we have seen now it is Rajasthan. Earlier it was Punjab, which has come up with the bills which has stalled or which has overcome or overridden the center's form laws, wherein the center has come up with the form laws. Now the Rajasthan assembly or the Rajasthan government or assembly has again made sure that they had gone ahead with coming up with the new bills, state bills in regards to the farms. And this, they say, that is the leader of opposition Gulab Chand Kataria said, the bills which went against the federal structure. So the leader of opposition is raising a concern against the Rajasthan government passing the bills to stall in the sense to not to accept the center's form laws. But the leader of opposition is saying that the bills introduced or passed in the Rajasthan assembly to stall the center's farmers laws or farmers bill is against the federal structure. Okay, the keyword here what we'll focus or what you need to focus is only the federal structure, but do not focus on what the leader of opposition is saying. Federal structure and a challenge the center's legislative domain. Challenging the center's legislative domain is the keyword. And the house has earlier rejected, that is the Rajasthan House Assembly has rejected the proposals to send bills for seeking public opinion. So the Rajasthan bill which has passed the bills to stall the center's form laws is now rejecting any kind of proposals for seeking public opinion. Public opinion. And the speaker of the house, that is Rajasthan speaker CP Joshi, says that there is not required for any changes to be done to the bills which have been passed in the Rajasthan House to stall the center's form laws, because it states that the objective of ensuring is the livelihood of the security of the farmers and protecting the minimum support price. So thereby making sure that ensuring the livelihood security of the farmers and protecting the minimum support price is the main objective of the bills which have been passed by the Rajasthan House. That is why there is no need to make any changes or a proposal to seek public opinion. Rather, directly they have passed the bills, which now these Rajasthan bills will stall the centers form bills. Now we will look at what are the three bills. This is very important. What are the three bills? That is Farmers Produce, Trade and Commerce, Promotion and Facilities, Rajasthan Amendment Bill 2020. So earlier the center is the Farmers Produce, Trade and Commerce, Promotion and Facilitation Bill 2020, and the bill now it is which has been passed in the Rajasthan is adding the Rajasthan Amendment, is the one which has been added to the center's bill. And the second one is the Farmers Empowerment and Protection Agreement on Price Assurance and Farm Services, Rajasthan Amendment Bill 2020. So the center is excluding the Rajasthan Amendment Bill, that is the bill or agreement on price assurance and farm services, and that has been amended by Rajasthan Amendment Bill 2020. And the third one is Essential Commodities Bill 2020, but amended by Special Provisions and Rajasthan Amendment Bill 2020. So these are the three bills which have been passed by Rajasthan. So now it is, earlier it was Punjab which has passed, or it has stalled the center's farm bills by passing the state laws or state bills. And now it is, after Punjab, it is now Rajasthan which has passed these three state bills in regards to the farmers. That is Trade and Commerce, Price Assurance and Farm Services, and Essential Commodities. And there is another news which talks about manufacturing grows faster since 2007. So almost 13 years, if you look at, the manufacturing is growing at a very fastest pace, and that is by a survey which has been taken up, and it says that India's manufacturing sector has been improved for the third straight month in the month of October. That means there is a growing output of the, or it is growing of the manufacturing output. There is a growth in the manufacturing output, and that we can see it in the last 13 years it wasn't so, but now because of the robust sales growth post COVID-19, that is post, if you look at from August, after August, that is September, and then August, September and October, if you look at, the manufacturing sector growth has been increasing very robustly, and it is at a very faster pace, and this growth is which was not there since last 13 years, that is from since 2007 it wasn't there, that is from 13 years this growth was not there, robust sales growth wasn't there, but now the manufacturing sector is growing. And if you look at the purchasing managers index, PMI, so this is PMI is Purchasing Managers Index. Now it has rose from 56.8 in September to 58.9. Wherein if you look at in the month of April, for 32 consecutive months, it was actually growing in a positive, but it has slipped in the month of April because of the COVID-19 pandemic situation, because of the global supply chain system was badly hit, and there was damage to the economic activity, and the business revival wasn't there. That is why the manufacturing sector growth was sharply declined, and that has declined for almost 32 consecutive months. The growth territory has slipped from April, but right from August, September and October, if you look at, the manufacturing is increasing, and if you look at above 50, it means expansion. That is what, if we focus here, for the month of September it is 56.8, and for the month of October it is 58.9. That means any purchasing managers index which is above 50, it means there is a growth in the manufacturing, and which is below the 50 level, that means there is a contraction or there is a negative trend in regards to the manufacturing growth. and the new orders or the output of the Indian manufacturers has continued to recover after what you say we have seen the contraction from the month of March, April, May, June, July, but from August, September, October there is a recovery. There is a recovery in regards to the manufacturing purchases index, and this is definitely a historical sharp monthly rates of expansion from or since 2007, which was almost for 13 years there was contraction or the growth was very low, but now it is above 50 PMI. That is, the purchases managers index has grown above 50, and that is the crucial one. And now we'll focus at the recapitulating of the DNA, what we have done throughout the session. So we have looked at this in regards to the polity point of view, that is Supreme Court versus, here it is Supreme Court versus Election Commission. And then here Attorney General is saying that there is no need for any consent to take up contempt of case against the Chief Minister of Andhra Pradesh, Jagan Mohan Reddy. So here contempt of court act, this is a keyword. And then High Court panel, that is, this is again in regards to the polity. The first three are basically from polity perspective for prelims as well as mains examination. Here the point is Attorney General, here it is Madras High Court Committee. Madras High Court Committee is questioning the Supreme Court. Here again Madras High Court versus the Supreme Court in regards to questioning the setting up of special courts to try MPs, because they say it cannot be by the judiciary or the executive but only through a statute. And then here Rajasthan has passed the bill, which is again in regards to the farmers welfare. This is bills again from polity point of view. And manufacturing, this is in regards to the economy. We have looked at the PMI, purchase managers index. So definitely this, I hope it was a very informative, knowledgeable session for almost for polity point of view. We have covered here in regards to the Supreme Court verdicts, and then Attorney General, Madras High Court's setting up a special court, and then the state governments passing the bills against the central laws which have been passed, and the we have looked at the PMI in regards to the economy point of view. So I hope this was an informative, knowledgeable one, and then certainly this will help you to have an edge over others in regards to the prelims as well as mains perspective for UPSC point of view. So I would say a very big thank you, and then good luck to you all. Do maintain consistency, stick to schedule, and then take care of your physical health and mental health to attain success. And then do like the video, share the video and subscribe. And I would say subscribe the AKS, IAS, UPSC Civil Services exam, English medium students. This you please subscribe the AKS, IAS, UPS Civil Services site exam, I mean the channel, so that from next week we will be shifting from the Telugu medium to the English medium, which is AKS, IAS, UPS Civil Services exam for English medium students. You please subscribe that so that you can follow my sessions, that is daily news analysis of AKS, IAS Academy at AKS, IAS, UPSC Civil Services English medium. And then do follow the or AKS, IAS website, and then do subscribe the Telegram link of AKS, IAS Academy, that is Advanced Knowledge System. And see you tomorrow at 7:30 a.m. for the daily news analysis. Thank you. Thank you very much.